Hello, my name is Allison Piazza, Health Sciences Librarian at Seton Hall University. Today I will be presenting a quick overview of evidence-based medicine. What is evidence-based medicine? Traditionally, clinical decisions were made on the basis of the expertise of the clinician. Health practitioners were making decisions based on personal experience, anecdote, or simply, this is how we do it. The medical literature was haphazardly utilized. Evidence-based medicine is defined as the conscientious, explicit, and judicious use of current best evidence in making decisions about the care of individual patients. EBM acknowledges patient preferences rather than clinicians' preferences should be considered first whenever it is possible to do so. In this model, the patient's preferences and actions, along with the patient's clinical state and circumstances, and the best available research evidence, are overlaid with clinical expertise. Clinical expertise, in other words, must expand to balance and integrate these three important factors. Now that you know what evidence-based medicine is, let's learn how to practice it through the five steps of EBM. The five steps of evidence-based medicine are also referred to as the five A's: ask, acquire, appraise, apply, and assess. First, ask. After evaluating the patient, the clinician must ask a clear, answerable question to be pursued. To find the answer to a problem, you need to start with a question. Getting the question right can be as important as getting the right answer. You'll remember from previous lessons using the finding information framework that questions are considered either background or foreground. Background questions ask for general knowledge about a process, condition, test, treatment, or thing. Answers to background questions are often best found in textbooks or narrative review articles. Foreground questions, meanwhile, ask for specific knowledge to guide clinical decisions. Foreground questions are structured with the acronym PICO. P stands for the population being addressed. I, the intervention or exposure being considered. C, the comparison intervention. O, the clinical outcome of interest. Armed with your carefully formulated clinical question, you need to acquire relevant evidence. Many resources and databases are currently available to acquire evidence. As such, we must familiarize ourselves with the pros and cons of each type of resource to determine when each one can best be applied. There is no one-stop shop for all clinical questions, but the finding information framework can definitely help narrow down your sources. Evidence has a hierarchy in clinical medicine. We want to base our clinical decisions on the highest credibility evidence available. This assumes the quality of evidence is equal. After we have acquired the evidence, we then want to critically appraise it. When appraising a study, you want to know whether it was done well, what the results were, and whether it is relevant to your patient. Depending on the focus of the article, there are questions you should ask yourself when reading. After the study has been critically appraised and you have determined that the study and results are valid, you need to decide if it applies to your specific patient and situation. Factors to consider include similarities between your patient and those in the study, the needs and wishes of your patient, the availability of said treatment in your practice. The last of the five A's is assess, where you stop and evaluate your decision-making. Evidence-based medicine is iterative, meaning that it builds on itself and is constantly being reshaped by the research evidence and the clinical expertise of those who practice it. As you move forward, there are a number of questions you should ask yourself. Their answers will help shape your practice in future situations. Was the diagnosis or treatment successful? What was the patient's response or attitude? What new information would help make a better decision next time? That concludes our brief introduction to the five steps of evidence-based medicine. We hope you noticed that, while evidence-based medicine might be a new term to you, it is a life cycle you have become familiar with through your studies. Thank you.